Great, you've added a bunch of events, but what are you going to do with all of those? SportsWest makes it easy for you to create calendars for each of your teams, seasons, competitions, and pretty much any variation of those in three different layouts. I'm going to walk you through how to use calendars to display your upcoming games and past results to show your visitors what your team has been up to. Let's create a new calendar by clicking the Add New button and name this calendar Fixtures and Results. We can scroll down to the Details section where we can filter through our events to select only the events we want to display that meet the criteria. Status. This is where we can select scheduled upcoming events or published past events, but for this calendar, we'll select all to display everything. Date is to filter through our events by date. We can select events that took place this week, today, or a date range for the events we'd like to display. Again, let's go ahead and select all to show everything. Competition. Here we can select a competition to further narrow down our events. Season. This is useful when we want to create a calendar from a particular season. For this calendar, I want to show every upcoming and past event, so let's leave this as all. We can choose a venue if we want to only display events that were played at a particular location. If we want to create calendars for each of our teams, we can do that by selecting the teams here. Again, I want to show all the events played by all teams, so we'll leave this as all. We can choose to sort our events by ascending or descending order. Generally, ascending order works best for fixtures or upcoming events, and descending order is ideal for results or past events. For now, I'll keep it as the default ascending order, which shows us events in the chronological order. So I've kept everything as the default, which should show all of our events. Let's click Publish and see what we have here. So now that we've published this calendar, we can see a list of the events that will be shown. Right now, this calendar is displayed in a calendar layout, but we also have the option to select list or block layouts. Let's go ahead and see what this calendar layout looks like by clicking View Calendar. Great, so this format will give our calendar a traditional calendar layout. We'll notice that the days where we have an event are highlighted, and we can hover over the date to see the details, which will show the teams that are playing and the time the event is taking place. We can also click on the date where it will take us to that event page. Now let's change the calendar layout to list format and click Update and view the calendar. So here we have the list format calendar. We have our different columns, date, event, time result, competition, and season. These were all checked in the calendar page. We can choose which column we want to display on our calendar by checking or unchecking these boxes. So let's say we only want to show the title, time result, and the article. We'll keep these checked and uncheck everything else. Once we've made those changes, go ahead and update. Now the calendar looks much more simple. If we want, we can change the way the title is displayed through the SportsWest settings page. Next, let's see what the blocks layout will look like. Select the blocks format and click Update and view the calendar. In the blocks layout, our team logos will be displayed on either side with the date and time result in the middle. This is another common format that we see in professional sports websites. Another cool feature we have in our calendar section is the iCal feed. This feature allows us to easily share this calendar with teammates, organizers, and friends. Click this blue icon next to iCal and it will launch in whatever program iCal is launching in. In this case, it's either going to be iCal for Mac or Google Calendar. We can also share this link by copying and pasting it into our website, sending it to friends and teammates, or simply selecting this link and importing it into our Apple, Outlook, or Google Calendar.